think we're going to need to stand for the shade, so you need the white shirt to come back.
Got the wrong shirt on. Got the wrong trousers, the wrong shirt. Don't get sun in the northeast, you know. It's I know, it
was me. I'll take a turn. You can see how they've got a mini shed floor and a rabbit hutch and various places to sleep and live. So, my voice isn't going to be on it, but I'm going to ask you to introduce yourself, and then if you're, I might ask you questions, or you can just talk. So it's a bit like, hello, I'm... And then you introduce.
If I say something stupid, can I say it can stop?
Okay.
And
you can do it again.
Oh dear.
Right, So this is animal enthusiast Moira interview. Take one. Okay. Introduce yourself and tell us about your wonderful antics in your house.
Well, my name is Moira Simpson, and this is Cripplepad Hedgehog Hospital, which is also my home, bungalow in Newcastle upon Tyne, and it's here that my volunteers and I. Dealing with lots of hedgehogs that are injured or sick and that come in almost daily or weekly.
How long has that been going on?
1999, so that's what, 16 years now I've been dealing with. And I've learnt a lot over the years, obviously, about hedgehog behaviour and animal welfare and what to do and what to treat them with the support of a good local vet and lots of good local volunteers.
And how many hedgehogs do you get coming through here each year, roughly?
It differs. I've had fewer hedgehogs this year, mainly because of personal circumstances and head injury, but we can have sort of around about 200 a year. We've treated now, we think, around 5,000, well, we've stopped counting, at 5,000 hedgehogs over that period of time that would have died. But the fact that they came, we treated them, rehabilitated them, and got them back out to most of them to their original home that they came from. So if it isn't suitable, then we find them a soft release site.
So you've got lots of different parts of your house thrown over to different activities. Can you take us through what would happen if a hedgehog arrived on your doorstep?
Yeah, when a hedgehog comes in, the first thing I do is we go into the garage, which doubles as a treatment room. It's converted into a treatment room, where I've got all the medicines and fluids, etc. And they're examined there in the treatment room. And if there's a need, then they go straight up to the vets if it's an emergency. And if not, then they're treated there and then with fluids and the appropriate medicines. And then they go from the treatment room into intensive care, which is also my third bedroom. And it's a very hot room. And they have heat pads in there because most sick hedgehogs are hypothermic, so they need heat. And then they're treated over the course of time in the third bedroom, intensive care. And then when they're well enough, they come out of there and they go into a shed behind me, also known as Cripplepad Hospital. And that's the second phase of their treatment. And then when they're well enough, they go into a rehabilitation area. Which is either pens, the lawn is normally covered in pens, so they're rehabilitated there, or in Tinkertown behind you, which is a miniature wildlife garden, or they go out to foster care, as I have a number of volunteers who foster care, and then they're released back into the wild again. And it can differ with their illness or their injuries, just how long that takes. Oh, and the bathroom, sometimes the bathroom doubles as a hydrotherapy pool, if they need physio, if I've done, you know, injured legs or injured back or something like that, then you get them swimming. So that's the bath.
So isn't it a bit difficult to let them go?
No. No, even the babies. I mean, you do get attached, right? But the whole point is conservation. I don't do this because they're cute creatures, although they are cute creatures, they're lovely, they're very endearing little mammals. I do it because as a species they're endangered with a prediction that they're going to be extinct within 10 years. And they need help, and we can't. It's us that cause them their problems. I'm afraid human beings, and if I can help them, I'll do what I can, basically.
That's good. Is there anything else you think you're going to say? Covered all the bases, and if we get some footage of the various areas, so
yeah,
we can drop that in as you're speaking. Does that work for you?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Ask Chris. Anything else, Chris, you think? Get the hooks on you.
Yeah.
Every hedgehog that comes in gets a pain mark on it, just a small emotion mark. This season's colours is orange for the girls and green for the boys. so that we know which year they came in. And that helps us identify which hedgehog. So when it's released, you can see there is actually webcams. If I do release them here and Chris releases them with webcams, and we monitor them nightly. And our experience knows when there's something wrong, or it's limping, or it's getting thin, or whatever. And we know which hedgehog that is. And it's only not that long ago that the hedgehog came in with paint marks on, and I went and had a look at it, and it was one that I'd released here in 2009. 6 years ago, so he's doing okay.
Okay.
Okay,
that's good.